If using a smartphone seems unnecessarily complicated, the Doroliberto 825 should change your mind. It is the first smartphone to think the way you do, making it the perfect choice for first-time users who want all the enjoyment a smartphone can offer, but in an easier, more intuitive way. Whether you are a fay with technology or not, the 825 makes doing what should be simple tasks simple, and more advanced tasks easier than you would have ever expected. The 825 is not boasting the very latest in high-end specifications, but it has everything required to offer a very respectable performance and keep you in touch and online at an affordable price. Some of the key specifications are shown on screen now. Premium glass and metals are not present on the Liberto 825. Instead, it is strong and resilient glossy plastics. Plastic is fantastic, remember, because it will sustain knocks, scratches and general wear and tear much better than some other materials. The 825 feels solid in the hand and like it could take a few drops. Not that I advise such. Above the 5-inch touchscreen display is the earpiece and Doro logo along with a front-facing camera, whilst below the screen are three physical silver buttons that give a tactile feedback when using. On the left side of the device are three metal connectors that work with the supplied charging dock. When docked, these metal connectors align with pins in the cradle to pass charge to the internal battery, saving you the hassle of connecting a physical cable to the phone itself. On the bottom of the handset is the micro USB port for charging the phone should you wish to connect the charging cable. The right side of the device is home to the power, volume and camera keys. Each are raised and easy to use, again with icons next to them to explain what they are. On the top is the headphone jack which you can connect 3.5mm headphones to. Flip the phone over and in the upper centre is the camera and flash with the assistance button just below it. Press and hold the assistance button to call or message pre-programmed contacts in the event of an emergency to alert them that you need assistance. The back cover is removable and under this is where you gain access to the battery compartment, the microSD memory card slot for expanding the internal 8GB of memory and the SIM card slot too. The 5-inch display is large enough to be functional but small enough that the phone does not feel too big or cumbersome to use. You need to remember that much of the software has been engineered to be a little larger in size, so icons and things do take up more of the screen space. When the keyboard is used, this will also take up about a third of the display or so, just something to consider if you think overall it is too big. It has a resolution of 720p that provides more than enough detail for 99% of things you are likely to do on this phone, and such a resolution also helps ensure you do not use too much battery power. Whilst heavily customised, the underlying software on the Liberto 825 is Android. You will have likely heard of this. Doro have spent a lot of time and effort customising this with what is known as a skin, which transforms the way in which you interact with the operating system. This is ultimately where the value is in the 825, as what can be an illogical OS, at times, has been simplified with this skin to make things logical. From the moment you take it out of the box, you are given a walkthrough of how to use key features on the phone and get to grips with using a touchscreen device. By the time you reach the end of the tutorial, things should be that bit more obvious and understandable. The best example of this is when it comes to sending a text message. On a normal Android phone, this would usually involve going to messaging, clicking new, selecting a recipient, and writing out the message to send. Is going to messaging obvious? What you ultimately want to do is send a message, so with the Doro 825, you click the big send icon, then choose message. That makes a bit more sense, does it not? You have options to personalise the wallpapers, ringtones and more if you choose, so you need not be stuck with what Doro offer. Apps are probably something you hear everyone talking about and or desire of a smartphone, and this is all perfectly possible here. The 825 has Google Play Store, which offers the largest library of applications on it. So whether you want to get games, a productivity tool, or even download a film right to your phone, you can. The 825 is very capable. You can create and edit a Word document or presentation, send emails and have them updated whenever you're connected to the internet. Use it in the car to navigate from point A to B, and much more. You have Wi-Fi to connect to wireless networks at home, at work or in public places where they're available. 3G and 4G connectivity is built into the phone, and subject to your mobile data plan with your mobile network provider, you can connect to the internet, send emails, browse web pages and do more wherever you are. Bluetooth allows you to connect to peripherals such as headsets, speakers, car audio systems and more. The micro USB connection on the bottom of the phone allows for charging, but also to connect to a computer for transferring data and files if required. There is an FM radio that can be used when you connect the headphones that are provided in the box, so you can pick up your favourite radio stations right from the handset. Hearing aid compatibility is also present, so if you have a compatible hearing aid, you can be assured of an improved audio quality when using the 825. The rear-mounted speaker is pretty loud, in fact it registers in at around 83 decibels, which for most things is loud enough. The rear-facing camera is rated at 8 megapixels. It has autofocus and flash to make capturing images even in low light easier and with more clarity. Image results on the whole were reasonable and acceptable on the most part. You can record video, but this is at 720p resolution and the results are perfectly acceptable. The 2000 mAh internal battery will last the lighter users about 2 days, with most general users needing to charge it every day. Unlike some feature phones, this will not give you a week's worth of battery, so if you think about leaving it in the car or at the bottom of a bag for emergency situations, this is not really the phone for the job. Out of all the phones I have tried and tested over the years, from leading brands to new startups, I have never seen or used a phone that makes the whole setup experience as simple as Doro do on the Liberto 825. The 825 is appealing to those who want a smartphone, who want to be able to call, email, text and browse the web on the go, but are less confident with what some may call newfangled technology. In all reality, it makes a user's first time experience of using a smartphone memorable and rewarding rather than frustrating and simply wanting to give up. Whilst the 825 would not be for me, personally, I can think of many people who could benefit from this type of handset and would likely hold a different opinion of smartphones having used one.